you have something to lose, whether you what your estimation of that is, and so clear that it was, it pissed me off again. I'm like, this won't stop with this bullshit. Just do one and get the the way and let
somebody else try. Don't
let somebody else do something.
But Dia, I have to be honest though. It's because you speak so boldly, man. And some people you just ain't gonna never be as cool as. Like somebody will never be as cool as you, Dia.
Oh,
like
I know
but be honest though. You see some people that are just cool and they have a thing. You have a way to reach people and fearlessly and fairly. So like when it comes to Minneapolis, after watching you, after being around Brian Stevenson and these other people, like I said, it's easy, man. It's like it's because the people on the front line, DL, when you're sitting there and we're talking to George Floyd's widow.
I saw.
You know what I'm saying? We're talking to her personally. The private conversation that I had with Armand Aubrey's father, when he's saying they took my boy from me, 26 years old, when he says, Jamie, how come they just didn't beat him up? Just beat him up if you have to, so I can nurse him back to what he is. He said, that was my baby. He said, my daughter who has a master's degree, how do I explain to her they killed my boy because he was jogging? And if you hear the vernacular, the way his father was speaking, because he had, you know, Southern English, but to see he had passed it forward to his kids. So now their wonderful education, now it's all shattered. And it's 100 of those cases that don't get the limelight, that have not been on television, because we have this thing called Circle of Mothers that Trayvon Martin's mother, Sabrina, heads up. Man, it's like we said, it's the least we could do. And I hate to make...
But some people make it the... Here's the thing, Jamie. I've never seen you in a situation. There are a few people I've said that I didn't believe you. Like, I believe you every time, and it's because I believe you were Ray. Like, yeah. I believe you. Like, I believe
radio.
I believe you. And I believe you because something in you. So it isn't about what you could lose. It's about you're quintessentially human, and to have accomplished all that you have is because there is a way that you have tapped into something that is very rare in any medium, humanity. And like I saw you, and you were talking about how you from Texas and how Jax is from Texas and how you know what that's like. I don't know how, because I have nothing, like literally all I am is what I am. You are embraced by all kinds of genres, and they might have a perception of this aspect, this shade of your humanity. That might be a casualty.
Well, here's what I say. There was a night, was it the Black Film Festival, and they gave me an award, man. ABFF, right? And Leonardo DiCaprio came out and gave it to me. I got to be honest with you. Them black people was like, that blew their head. like, God damn it! But what I told Leo, I said, man, if you come and give this award, you know, for black folks, man, you know, it would take what they're doing all the way out the stratosphere. He didn't even blink. You know, he was like, yo, man, that's, you ain't got to even give me that spiel. I'm there. A lot of people don't even know his background. Q-Tip is one of his best homies. Dude stood in line for the Biggie album. So it's a whole thing, right? But when I made the speech, I said this, and maybe you agree with this. If I don't have black fans, I don't really have anything. And that's a real thing, because what we do is we struggle to get to a certain point in our life because we, you know, they've always told us to be mainstream. But what I have always understood, that if my black fans aren't proud of what I am doing, then somehow it doesn't feel the same. And so therefore, I'm always connected to that. I will always say that. Even when Ray Charles, you talk about that with the Oscars, when we were doing that whole Oscar run, I got a call. You'll appreciate this. And it was like four or five people online. You know, is everybody on?
Right.
Who wants to go first?
It's Charlie right now, yeah.
Yeah, who wants to go first? Jamie, we feel that Ray, you know, you've been saying that it's an African-American black story, but isn't it really a human story? Do we have to keep saying black? Now, this is just before the Oscars. These are people that I've known.
Right.
I said, first of all, let me say this. all y'all on this motherfucker. Right. That's the first thing. I said, and you don't even understand the business of it. If I say black, the business is, they say black films don't go to Oscars like this. If we continue with the true narrative that is a black story, what about the next time someone's in a meeting and says, hey, Ray Charles did this. It was a black story. It did that. From then on, it's a business thing as well. But how can we get to this point and all of a sudden you want to snatch that away from me? And you thought that I was maybe one of these guys who'd be like, you know what, you're right. I'm trying to keep doing business with y'all. You know, you got a point. No, man. You have to let it be what it is. At night, it was what it was. They all celebrated. Nobody even thought about it. Because we love seeing someone celebrate their culture. We love seeing Seinfeld. We love seeing whatever gangster Italian movie. So why not let us have our moment? And we took it a step further, DL. We didn't go to the Vanity Fair party. Dave Brown threw a party at some other little hideaway spot. And we went over there and we kicked it over there.
You know what I love about you, Jamie? Wow. People don't know this. I watch you win the award, and I also watch you at the Milwaukee Jam for Peace, where you whooped the whole arena's ass, and you've been doing it ever since. And you've been doing it ever since. To me, you a gangster from Terrell, Texas. I know who you are.